Yo, it's Jeff Williams, and we outside for real, for real.
In Mississippi from the south, Atlanta, Georgia from the south. That's why we doing it all Southside, the Southside, yeah, the Southside, the Southside. Everybody do the Southside, the Southside, yeah, the Southside, the Southside. Raise your hands and do the Southside, the Southside, yeah, the Southside, the Southside. Shock it, rock it, do the Southside, the Southside, yeah, the Southside, the Southside. It's fine, it's going to produce. Ain't giving niggas fab, you know the Southside acting bad on the track. We throwing up the boots. Ain't giving niggas fab, you know the Southside acting bad on the track. Alright, we throwing up the boots. Ain't giving niggas fab, you know the Southside acting bad on the track. I'm throwing up the boots. Ain't giving niggas fab, you know the Southside acting bad on the track. I woke up early, jumped in that water, socks and shades, bushes, blades, and the bowls burn rubber. I swung and I swang, you know a nigga swing. Hit the velvet and the team, Europeans with the scream. Big ol' boat twankin', everything cash. Glass top red, folded wood in the dash. Mashing on the gas, here's a thug like green. Front boy, yonder, I see knock in the beam. Showing naked ass and the story's about to kill you. 1700, wet apple over silver. Hit the school zone, 418 shook it. Caught that little dude sideways, sitting crooked. Pulled his ex gun, nothing less. This supreme, never slipping, but I'm drippin' candy red on the scene. Flouncing on the hoes, tossing on the women. Gotta pop the truck for that nigga Pat Lemon. Alright, we throwing up the boots, ain't giving niggas bad. You know the Southside acting bad on the side. We throwing up the boots, ain't giving niggas bad.
Hey man, say man. Middle fingers to a hater. If you go outside to get to that money every motherfucking day, man, we outside for real, for real. And it's your boy Grip, man. And as you can tell, yeah, we outside for real, man. And today we got my boy Jeff Williams from Paducah, Kentucky. We out here at Robert Coleman Park, better known as Blackburn, you know, south side of Paducah. That's where you from, ain't it, my dog?
Facts, 100%.
Yeah, that's why I played 100%. That for you, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, we finna get into it, man. I heard your name first popping when the Sundayz In The Park started this year. I ain't really know who you was, you know what I'm saying? Then you had reached out to me. We was supposed to been made it happen. But, you know, for everybody that don't know, man, I ain't dropped no content in like 2 months. I was going through a custody battle for my son. You know, it's a kind of messed up situation. I'm gonna do an episode on it once I'm done recording. I'm done recording next month. I'm gonna do an episode on it and tell y'all everything, cause I think some men might get some valuable information out of this. You know what I'm saying? Not trying to brag or nothing, but I'm finna be 2 out of 3. Get my kids custody of them, 2 out of 3 of them. You know, I'm finna have custody of them, you know. And I ain't the perfect father. I ain't saying that. I ain't trying to be neither, but I'm a father, like a real one, you know what I'm saying? But enough of that. Like I said, that's the reason I ain't dropping no content. I just want y'all to know I appreciate everybody that's been rocking with me, still reaching out, asking me what's up. I appreciate that, and continue to rock with me. But back to my dog, Jeff Williams, man. So, all right, boom. Sundayz In The Park. Did you start that, or is that something that was already going on and you just kept it going?
I definitely created it with my best friend, Rome. Shout out to Rome. Once I had moved back in 2018, we just kind of, you know, at his crib, kind of sitting around trying to figure out something to do outside of just the club life and kind of the typical things that we had going on. It was just like, man, you know what? We need to get us some music going, get some food going, and just take it to the park like it was back when we were younger. So I don't want to ever say, like, we created, yeah, Sundayz In The Park, but that whole Sunday vibe where we all come and congregate and kick it and vibe, see people throughout that you don't see throughout the week on the regular, but we all can come to one spot and, you know, not have any BS going on and leaving that at home and seeing the kids play and all of that. Yeah, we did create that. But like I said, it was just a recreation of what we grew up getting in this very park, Blackburn, and then also Noble Park growing up. So, yeah.
All right. And for those that don't know what Sundayz In The Park is, can you speak on that topic, like what it's all about?
What it's about, we started out small, like I said, with just a speaker and just kind of barbecuing. But then we doing an interview. How you doing? We doing good. But how it started was, what it's all about is, it morphed into something small and just trying to have somewhere to go to into being able to give kids free food every Sunday. And then having sporting events like the Northside versus Southside, basketball games or kickball games. And then, it just kind of got pretty big, man, to where we was pulling out about 200, 300 people every weekend. And it's been going since about 2021. And hopefully, man, it goes forever, man. Even once I'm gone, man, I hope the kids and the next generation be able to take it to new levels.
Man, that's what's up. And, you know, I respect that because you give it back to your hood, like especially the younger generation, because, you know, I'm seeing the younger generation compared to like how we was growing up, the people my age, even though we was doing a lot of things that wasn't right. But now it's like, it's kind of out of control, like as far as with the respect level for older people. Now ain't nobody fighting or anything, shooting, you know what I'm saying? Like it's serious out here. And I feel like, you know, like TV, music, all that influencing them real bad. They ain't understanding any people they listening to ain't even living this type of life no more. You right, know what I'm saying? Right. Even if they was even living it in the first place. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But 100%. Yeah, big ups to y'all, man, for doing something positive, giving back to the hood. I ain't never get to come. I was going to come when y'all did the Northside versus Southside basketball game. I think I seen y'all do it in the gym one time, and then I seen y'all do it out here at the park, if I ain't mistaken. But yeah, man, I definitely salute what y'all doing for the city, man.
That's love. I appreciate it.
Because, you know, you can always be like, oh, this my hood, but what have you did for your hood?
100%. Facts.
You know what I'm saying? Who cares if it's your hood if you ain't did nothing positive, try to get back? You know, y'all see the hood is messed up around here, so we got to do something, especially for them younger generation, you know what I'm saying? You got to show them the right way, because them penitentiary bunks ain't gonna never get old. They're gonna always be there, you know what I'm saying? And they making money off you while you in there, just in case you didn't know that. So, you know, that's how they staying rich. What you doing dumbass shit. So, you know, to the younger generation, you know, it ain't all what it seems. You feel me? That other side ain't that other side real. It ain't what's up. For real. So you grew up in Paducah, you were born and raised here?
Man, born and raised, man. It's crazy, man. You know, I rep Southside to the death, man. But man, one argument I got with the whole city is, man, they say, oh, Jeff from the north, Jeff from Hillside, he from all these places. But man, to be truthful, man, like I'm a real live Paducah baby, man. The reason why even reaching out to you and seeing your other interviews, man, pretty much everybody that you done dealt with, from Sack Leader Wine to YM, Fly Paper, like, man, I grew up with these guys, and not just in passing on the school bus, but man, like real live memories with them. But like where I learned music, when I found out who I was really gonna be and had these aspirations, it started right here in this neighborhood, you know what I'm saying, South 13th.
That's what's up. So you was in the sports anything growing up in high school?
Basketball, man, that was my sport, man. Never played too much of anything else outside of, like, you know, in the neighborhoods and stuff like that. But basketball, man, I just knew, you know, from M1, wanting to be Hot Sauce, to Allen Iverson taking over the world. Like, I just knew I got NBA aspirations. But, you know, man, I'm a little height challenge and everything, man. So it got me through and everything. But basketball was pretty much it, man. Played varsity, went to state 2 years in a row.
What year was this?
What'd you say?
What year was this?
2007 and 2008.
Yep. Who I played with you?
My guy E was backup point guard for him. Stefan, my guy Brock, Fuji, Isaac, man, just a bunch of guys, man. But, you know, we kind of made a family out of it. Like, you know, and they're still my brothers to this day. But, like, yeah, man, we took it real serious, man. And we went down there and tried to do, you know, tried to put on, man. We got as far as we could, but yeah, man, I don't regret anything, man, about that. Loved it.
That's what's up. So you graduate and go to college, anything like that?
Yeah, in 2008, graduated that fall, went to the University of Louisville, diehard Cardinals fan, you know, somebody UK players and fans since we in the state of Kentucky, but you know, I'm red to the end, man, after I get out of high school bleeding blue, but went to University of Louisville and didn't finish, but as of right now, you know, I'm finishing up my undergrad, but like I said, college, I did go to college, and I don't take no regrets from it, from the networking to the things that I learned, the people that I met on campus, long life friendships. But yeah, shot down at Louisville and was down there for about 10 years.
Yeah, shout out to Louisville, man. It's like kind of like my second, third home. I done lived there a couple times, and I got family up there, and my mom actually lived up there. I got a cousin that went to school, U of L, met somebody there. He been married to him since he went to school there. Yeah. My cousin Corey.
You find true love on them campuses,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, for sure. My cousin Corey and his wife Tiffany, shout out to them. I know they be watching my podcast and stuff, so shout out to them, man. And I want to give another shout out, man. I got a cousin named Adrian Harper, man. He got a podcast called I Respectfully Disagree, man. You know, if y'all would, man, help him get to that 500. And with me, too, we trying to get to 500 subscribers. We got, like, 400. I got, like, 460. He got, like, 440 maybe. You know, support it. Don't cost nothing to make a YouTube page and, you know, hit that subscribe button and try to support people that's trying to do something positive. You know, not no negative shit. We trying to bring positivity and light into what's going on in Western Kentucky and let them know, you know, people is out here doing positive things and good things for the community, like my dude Jeff right here in front of the camera, you know what I'm saying? And my bad for getting off topic, but I seen you get a, you just got an award for something, right?
Yeah.
I can't really say what it was because I seen the post, but I ain't really, maybe I wasn't reading it right, but I ain't really just see what the award was for.
Man, it was for View Magazine, man. It's called the 40 Under 40, and it's not just in Paducah, it was for the region, so,
okay,
you know, in the Western Kentucky area, I guess Purchase area, something like that, but yeah, man, it came out September 1st, man. If you all around town in this area, man, definitely get you a copy of that, man. Some good write-ups and some good people in there.
Yeah, and my dog on the front of the magazine, man. That's what's up, man. So how'd you feel when, like, did you find out about it before they put it out?
Yeah, they let me know, man, that I was selected, and like how you was asking me how I feel about it, man. Definitely, man, since I've been an adult, haven't really gotten any awards, a lot of ups and downs and things like that, so I definitely greatly appreciated the opportunity and get some good looks from, you know, anybody that's happening from their market, you know. But to be all the way real, man, a lot of people keep asking me, like, man, how you feel about it and things like that. And it's like, greatly appreciated, like I said. But then also, man, like, I don't, validation coming from a magazine and, you know, that culture, I appreciate it. But, man, every day that I'm out here moving around in the neighborhood and you see how people riding by, hollering at me and
yeah, it's been like that nonstop since we've been out here, even before we cut the camera on.
Yeah, so
what,
like,
what y'all doing?
Definitely.
Hey, boy. Oh, the women, you know, that's how I know you, like, respected, and they know you doing something good. I just seen, like, before the camera got put on, a woman pulled up and was like, what you doing? And, you know, yeah, he explained to her,
you know,
what we was
know.
Doing. And she was like, I'm glad you're doing good out here, and I appreciate what you're doing for the community. When you see my son, say something to his knucklehead tail. So, you know, they let me know, like, you know, people see what you're doing, you know.
But that's the validation
right
bro,
that speak measures, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I know it got to feel good for older people to come by and, you know, give you that type of respect and love at the same time.
Yeah, most definitely. But that's the validation right there, man. That's, you know, every day, man, from the younger generation to the oldest, elders, them even knowing, like, you know, that's what pushed me. So, like I said, man, I appreciate the award and everything, but man, my neighborhood, my community, man, every day they push me harder and make me, you know, put that fire up under my butt to keep this thing going and, you know, reach different levels and higher levels and everything.
For sure, for sure. So, what would you like to do next, like, for the community? You know, you're doing the Sundayz in the Park. What's the, like, the end goal? Well, I ain't gonna say you even got an end goal, but what's, like, one of your goals to get done in your community?
Well, in my community, man, I feel like, man, we got a lot of talent, man. We from the little girls to the little boys to my peers, the women and the men. it's not really a goal, but I guess, man, just pushing positivity, because like you said, man, with the internet and the music, and not trying to sound real old, like, oh, is that rap music and all of that, but it's just still though, like, man, trying to give it a different look, because, man, my community never gave up on me, man. I made a lot of bad mistakes in my 20s and stuff, and I'm still figuring it out every day, but just being able to not give up on my community, because we from a small town, and a lot of people feel like it's not no hope here, or countdown of days to get out of here, man. I'm ready to move away. And it's real, man, like, it's a lot of history, it's a lot of rich souls around here, man, and just trying to bring that back or keep it going, because, you know, hearing the histories of the 8th of August and all these different things that went on,
yeah,
man, like, I just want to be able to keep that story alive and keep it going. Man. You messing up my interview, Big Mama. She's crazy, man. I love her, though, man.
Hey, shout out to Big Mama, though, who gave us the batteries, man. Shout out to her. You said she was going to build a block and see what you was doing, didn't you?
Yeah, she definitely did.
Hey, you sure called it out, I tell you.
She was going to come check out the neighborhood, man. That's my heart right there, man.
That's what's up, man. But yeah, man, it was good to meet you, man. And if you got anything you want to say, you know what I'm saying, to the Paducah community or anything, right now is definitely the time.
Just with my foundation, CGL, and that stands for Community Growth Legacy Foundation, my nonprofit. I'm just, one thing that I do want to put out there is just like a slogan that I got is, your community is your family. And I just want us to remember that and never forget it, because, you know, man, from senseless beef, we got younger kids picking up those packs and trying to make some money, man. And I think, man, if we all come together, man, that's from the street guys to the professionals, to our athletes, to all that, man, we come together, man, we gonna be able to save that next generation. And then they just gonna make us look better, man, and put us on the map. Everything that we fall short on, they gonna be able to reach.
For sure, man. I definitely feel that. Definitely. But when we talked on the phone, and that son, man, got my camera messed up. I'm looking at it, man.
The elements.
Ain't focusing right. Yeah, man. We'll make it right though. But when we talked on the phone, we was talking about books. We'll talk about this before we dip. And I asked you, have you read Think and Grow Rich or Black Choice? You was like, man, what? Told me who it was by. So what you think about that book, though?
Man, that book is amazing, man. I got it from my daughter's grandfather. When I first met him, passed me the book by the author Dennis P. Kimbrough. And it was one of those books, when I started reading it, I was just like, you know, usually I just try to read and, you know, I'm going to remember things and consume it. But once I got through that first chapter, I said, hold on, I got to start this over. It's time for me to pull out the notepad and the pen and start taking these notes. And like I was kind of telling you, man, one of my favorite quotes in that thing is, if you take care of your pennies, man, the dollars will take care of themselves. And you know what I took from that was just like saving and being, because we all can get money, man. We all got 1,000 hustles. But man, that money management is everything, you know? So, you know, especially with me pushing the whole black dollar, keeping that dollar circulating in our community and stuff, man, just, you know, taking a sense of pride in ourselves and that entrepreneurial spirit that we have, just, man, honing in on it, man, and chasing them dreams, and then that money gonna come later, man. It's gonna follow up right behind it, man. So that's definitely what I take from that book. That's one of my favorite books ever.
Yeah, that book powerful, man. And if y'all ain't ever read that, and if y'all in the read, man, y'all definitely need to go grab that, man, and you know, give it a read, man. It's called Think and Grow Rich, A Black Choice by Dennis Kimbrough. Yeah.
Most definitely.
Whole lot of knowledge in there, man, for real.
Full of knowledge.
Because the black community ain't really taught financial literacy. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can say what you want, but, you know, I know I wasn't taught that. You know, and I know a lot of other people that I grew up with wasn't taught that. Like you said, people knew how to get money, but they ain't really know what to do with it.
It's about saving, man. It don't seem like nothing cool about saving and wanting to spend it, but once you start seeing it stacking up, hey, it start becoming a habit then.
For sure, man. But man, I ain't gonna hold you long, man. I don't want the interview to just drag on me, just ask you a whole bunch of crazy questions. But I'm glad, man, we got to link up, man. It was past due. You feel me? I'm glad you got to get your stuff out here, man. And keep doing what you're doing, man, no matter what nobody say, because, you know, it's always gonna be hate when you doing something positive, no matter 100%. What. So I know you didn't face that, too. But just keep doing what you're doing, man. Like, it's well-respected. Like, I seen it for myself just sitting here. We sitting right here on a corner. You know what I'm saying? There's been numerous of cars that came through here. And they ain't said nothing but good stuff, you know. And it's a whole bunch of people stopping. So it let me know, like, you respect it. Because if you wasn't able to keep going, wouldn't be no stopping. Be like, what them niggas doing there?
Well, man, I also want to say, man, I appreciate you for having me on your platform and even responding to me, man, because,
man, for sure.
You know, man, seeing your whole setup and what you out here doing, man, you really pushing positivity, man. So I definitely wanted to be a part of it, man. Like I said, man, thank you again for letting me
for
be
sure,
a part
man.
Of it.
Yeah, you know, I'm finna try to switch it up, man, because I don't want them to just think it's about rap. I know people get on here and see a couple of interviews and see people smoking weed and stuff like that, and they'll get to, you know, judging off the muscle, not even knowing who the person is. You know, everybody got skeletons. Yep. You know, some people just choose the shoulders. Like, and I don't look at weed as no bad thing. And, you know, my channel ain't for kids neither. That's another thing. You know, when I put my videos out, I put not for kids, because this ain't for kids. It's for grown folks. You know, so if you're letting your kids watch it and they seeing people, hey, that's on you. Because I'm telling y'all now, this is not for no kids. You know what I'm saying? But like I said, everybody got their skeletons and their little dirt they do. So I don't really be trying to judge people anymore. I had that bad at one time, you know, trying to judge somebody. But you ain't never know what nobody done been through.
Right, right.
So it ain't good to judge people, especially when you don't know what they really, really. If it ain't somebody you really, really know, grew up with, mm-hmm. something like that. And then even if you did, you still don't need to be judging them. You know what I'm saying? Because, hey, who can judge you?
That's a fact.
You feel me? But again, man, I appreciate you, man, coming on here. And yeah, we trying to push positivity. I'm going to get to touching on different topics and stuff, you know, trying to switch it up where it just ain't rappers, you know. I got a couple little things lined up with some dudes that play sports, so, you know, I'm trying to get that on here. I'm trying to get a couple people on here with that's married, you know, get to talking about marriage and stuff like that, people that own businesses. I just hollered at X. I'm going to try to get him on here. I seen he opened up a barbecue place, man. That's real. I've been knowing him for some years and to see him, you know what I'm saying, overcome what he had to overcome with the leg injury and then, you know, doing something like this. That's a major move in my eyes.
That's a real one, too.
Yeah, he ain't letting nothing keep him down, you know. Yeah, that's good. And that's another thing because, like, I know, you know, another thing I wanted to talk to him about was, like, like depression, because I know he had to been like lightweight, you know, depressed, going through something like that, being able to walk. Then the next day, you messed up, you missing, you know what I'm saying? Just want to talk to him where his headspace was, how he ever came there. Because, you know, I ain't afraid to speak on it, but, you know, I be fighting with depression. Like, you know, I let a lot of stuff get to me and stuff. You know, that's why I ain't make no content. It wasn't that I was just depressed, it was just stressed and kind of depression and just real stuff going on with my son. You know what I'm saying? Like, I take my kids serious, you know what I'm saying, when it comes to them.
Supposed to.
You know what I'm saying? Because I feel like I'm all they got. I ain't going to say that they ain't got their mothers or nothing like that, but I got to play my part because, you know, we get put down so much. You know, they always saying, you know, men don't do this for their kids or do that. Like, you know, I'm finna have custody of two of mine. Like, I'm fighting. You know what I'm saying? No matter what, for mine. You know, I'm trying to keep my words right. You feel me? So I don't get to talking too crazy. You know, and when I talk, I ain't even going to bring up my kid's mother. But I'm gonna bring up all the bullshit she did, because she took me through a whole lot of bullshit, bro, that wasn't necessary just to try to save face. You know what I'm saying? And it wasn't right as far as, like, I'm talking lying. Got my son lying on me. Just, man, but that's another topic, man. I'm getting off topic, but Yeah, I'm going to speak on all that. Like I said, I go to court next month on the 18th, and it should be over with. And then I'm going to speak on the whole thing. But yeah, man, anytime you got something going on, man, I'm going to try to pop out, man. My bad, I ain't get to pop out to none of the Sundays in the park, man.
We got more.
They was lit for sure. I was seeing them on social media. They was lit for sure, man. But, man, I appreciate you coming through again, man. Before we leave, man, I need you to tell them who you is one more time and tell them we outside for real, for real.
And it's Jeff Williams again, man, and we outside for real, man. Southside.
Atlanta, Georgia, from the side. That's why we doing the all Southside, the Southside, yeah, the Southside, the Southside. Everybody do the Southside, the Southside, yeah, the Southside, the Southside. Raise your hands and do the Southside, the Southside, yeah, the Southside, the Southside. Shock and rock and do the Southside, the Southside, yeah, the Southside, the Southside. It's time to throw on the produce and give it the style. You know the Southside. Bad on the slack, we throwing up the juice and giving.